One of the most powerful tools in the history of the world, besides the lathe, is a filter. With filters, we can take a collection list and show only the items that match whatever filter or filters we create. Here's a collection list. It's showing the collection items that match whatever settings we've already configured. But if we add a filter, maybe we want to showcase items in our collection that are switched to featured. What we would have to do is create a switch for featured. Well, good news. When we made this collection, we created a switch for featured. Just a simple switch field. This way, collaborators, when they're creating or modifying a collection item, they can choose whether or not to flick the switch. In our filter, we can make sure to select items which have featured switched to on. So that's done. Now, what do we have to do to update our collection list? Absolutely nothing. While we were talking, it did this for us. We're only seeing the items which are switched to featured. And we don't have to do this each time. Filters will always respect the most current content. So if we're making changes, creating new items, modifying items, filters will do their work automatically. Let's look at another example. Here we're on a collection page for our blog, and at the bottom, we're featuring blog posts inside a collection list. But it doesn't make much sense at all to feature the blog post we're currently on. We don't want the current blog post to show up in our collection list. How do we solve this? There are two ways. One, we could delete the project. Or two, we could use a filter. In our collection list, under collection list settings, we can go in and add a filter that specifies that this collection item, the blog post, is not the current blog post. And when we hit save, our current blog post will no longer be visible. It's been filtered out from our collection list. Here's one last example. What if our blog posts have different categories? Not from an option field, but from a reference field. In other words, we have a dedicated collection for our categories. It has the category name, it has the category color. And back in our other collection, our blog posts, we've created a reference field which lets us select from those categories. Back on the canvas, we're in the blog post here, we can select our collection list and go back over to create a filter. This time, we can go in and access that reference field. We can access our categories. So we can say, show categories that equal the current category. That means on this particular blog post, down here, we'll only see items related to the current category. Or we can change the logic to does not equal. That way, it will show every other category except the category applied to the current page. So, filters, super powerful way to select which content is shown, and just as importantly, which content isn't shown in a collection list.